don't have time, would have had more fun. Jesus, you are good. They overcame him by and the word of their testimonies. Testimonies are powerful tools to bring down the camp of the enemy. Every time you give a testimony, God is saying, so you could testify. It's like you are losing his hands to do more. I hear there are many testimonies that some people are looking at me now. You call me this week again to give me a testimony. Please give your testimony. Hallelujah. You might not take all, but testimony are for your own best interest. Testimonies are not for pastor. Pastor has never performed a miracle. Pastor does not know how to heal people. But he knows someone who can heal, and that person is in the name of Jesus. Shout Jesus.
Jesus.
Do not pass me by. Say it like you mean it. Jesus.
Jesus.
Do not pass me by.
Do not pass me by.
Whenever we say do something, it's prophetic. All over the Bible, we know, of course, that every time Zacchaeus wanted to receive, he shouted. We know that when the woman with the issue of blood wanted to receive, he shouted. We know Jacob shouted, say, I will not let you go until you bless me. Hannah stood and she cried out and she could not pray anymore. Hallelujah. They were groaning in her spirit. That was a shout of, I want my answers now. We can go on and on and on. So until you shout and God hears your voice, sometimes the testimonies can be delayed. But I'm sure by this encounter, your testimonies are coming to you in the name of Jesus. We had some testimonies from last week. We'll take them first and take some more before I preach. We have just 15 minutes. So that, tell us your testimony. You wanted to testify last week. And he's looking at me now. Shout hallelujah. Shout hallelujah.
Just a quick one. Last week, thank you, Jesus.
Hey, Pastor David.
Last week, I wanted to testify. It was basically, we've been talking about how even when the man's ways pleases God, he makes his enemies also be at peace with him. I was at home and then I got a call from one of my colleagues. He has always been critical of my work. He's always trying to make fun of me, trying to make me look bad. But I've always ignored him. So this time I called and he talked to me about a certain job I had done in the past and telling me not to worry, because I had had previously calls concerning that job that they were complaining that there were problems with. But this colleague of mine, who's very critical, is a very experienced chap, he knows the job. So he called me out of the blue, because I hadn't told him anything. He called me out of the blue and said to me, David, don't worry. What the work you did was correct. It is they who have their problem. And I was like, wow, I didn't expect, because if he calls me, he's calling me to complain or to criticize me. But when he called, he said, don't worry, your work has been
done. Wow. This is the shout of God. Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
1:26 says,
yes.
When the Lord turned again the captivity, okay. And that's not the testimony he told me. He told me something else about the peace of life.
Oh yes, hallelujah.
So you see, there are many.
This is another battle that we were going through. I told Pastor, we prayed, he told me, gave me one instruction. Say, change the guy. Change the guy.
Say instruction.
Instruction.
Hallelujah. The way you're saying is too vague. It looks so sweet. He had this problem with land and he was going on and on and on and on. And one day we're praying and he told me about it. And all I heard while we're praying is tell him to change whoever is in charge of the land.
Mm.
The land is not here, it's back home in Ghana. Mm. I told him, as soon as you change that person, the land will be yours.
Mm.
And everything will go back in place. And what happens? Yes. After that person was changed?
Everything is in place. And they brought in the big person.
Hallelujah. Are you just sitting like that?
Hallelujah.
Are you just sitting like that?
Hallelujah.
You don't understand the magnitude. They call them satanic divorce.
Yes.
They make you spend money and you don't see anything.
Yeah.
That's why some of us, when we send money back home, you call them again and say, I don't know. They lie. Sometimes they even lie to you that they did what you tell them to do and they don't do it. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
And that's what was about to happen to him, but God came in and stopped the divorce. Shout glory.
Glory.
Say, Jesus, thank you.
Jesus, thank you.
Let's call Sister Anna. She had a testimony last week. We didn't have time to take it quickly.
Amen.
Are you glad, oh Jesus? Every time you clap for a testifier, you attract your testimony.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I just want to thank God for Johnny Mercy.
Amen.
I went back home with speed, like an emergency situation. God prepared everything for me there. I was not really expecting that I'll be the testimony of this one, that when I was going, I nearly missed my flight from France. When I got to France, they said the flight would be delayed. We were meant to leave at 2:30, and they said we leave at 4. So I got to France at 9:30. So from 9:30 to 4 is a long waiting time. So I have my younger sister in France, say let me visit her, pay her visit. I went there. On my way back to the airport in the afternoon, there was a traffic on the road. Instead of 70, the road 70 per mile per hour, it was 10 we were going. And I was meant to be at the airport at 3, boarding at 3. But I got to the airport at 3:50. My only prayer was, God,
tell me again. You meant to be at the airport at 3.
3.
And you got there at 3:50.
3:50.
And you still made your flight.
It's all about. But my prayer was, God.
Why is a flight though?
God,
me talking like this.
God of fire me. Oh my God, fire means you. God of fire means you.
Jesus to our fathers.
Be that flight on the floor.
Amen. Amen.
My name is going to be off the gate.
And it's with Air France.
With Air France.
They are the same people that told me not to board the flight.
So when I got there, I saw wrong. The devil was even putting his people on the way. And they're checking, security check.
To delay.
Something is in the bag. We don't find it. I said, you must find it because I must enter this one. So, as I was going at the gate, when I was going, the woman at the gate for the passport to enter the flight. Who are you? I told her my name. She said, no, I can see your name. But since the 15, over 15 years I've been here, I've never seen somebody.
Wow.
Wait, wow. The flight waiting for somebody. My sister, she's in France, the one I went to see in France, I missed her, almost missed the flight. So when I got to home, the second day they called me that she's in prison. I said, what for? And that name, Apostle Smith called the name the last prayer night we were here, but I couldn't get any information from heaven. So he told me, don't worry. So they called me, she's in prison, she'll be arrested. What for? Because she has an Italian permit.
In France.
She's allowed to be there with it anyway. So I don't know why she's arrested. So when I find out, they said her stepbrother called the police for her because he had been all the time looking for how to put her in trouble. Because he was jealous of her being there. So he said she beat his son and broke his rib. So he called the police. Now the police came, they carried out, they said child abuse. Now, as they were interrogating the children to know what really happened, because he manipulated the children to accuse her. Now, when they were interrogating the children one by one, the story was different. But I couldn't go and join Papa because he was Nigeria then, and I was even trying to get internet when I got there. Even Mama, it's 3 days after I sent a message I have arrived. So I couldn't get Papa, but what the only way I know to pray is the God of water and fire.
Hallelujah.
Amen. This, anyway, God, as God wants, we have it. When they interrogated the children, the story was different from the one for their father. So the police found out that there's something wrong. So the next day, they released her. They released
her. And I hear something like that. Hallelujah. Even in this country, that's a very serious allegation. Only God can take you out of such allegations.
Now, when they took the child to the hospital, for this investigation people, the hospital to do the scan. As they they did it, there was nothing on the child. There was nothing where the child was. The father said the bruise was. There was no even bruise. There was no anything there. So this how now the case turned back. The police was asking you, what now are you saying?
Back to sender.
Do are you pressing charge for your brother or what? Well, she said, I will think about it. Well, only to make him to know that there is a God in heaven.
Yeah. Shout glory. Thank Jesus. Thank Jesus. Father, we just celebrate you. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
We shall take one or two more. Brother Clement, please clap for him as he comes. Come and tell us what God has done for you. Are you clapping for Jesus? Tell us what God has done for you.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I went there and I was looking for a few somewhere, but finally I got to see the so what I went for
was okay. And I'm here to thank God for Johnny Mercy. And there was something I've been expecting for so many years. And, you know, I made a preparation towards that. So by the time I came back last week, 3 days ago, I got a phone call. That expectation had been established by God. So more to come.
Yes.
I give a good testimony towards that.
Amen. I pray for you, may God perfect them in the name of Jesus. I release 100 legends of Word and Fire Ministry all over that building. Whatever you are trusting God for, let it come speedily in the name of Jesus. A prophecy for one is a prophecy for all. Shout hallelujah. Last one, Sister Chinere, come quick. Let's hear your testimony. Please, we have a lot of Adeline, Sister Adeline. We have a lot of Adeline, so if you are giving your testimony, Adeline, come forward. Write your second name so we know who we have a lot of Adeline's in here. Clap for her, she comes from a place. Tell us what God has done quickly.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I want to use the opportunity to thank God for my papa and their
thank
house.
God for God.
For my mama and daughter.
To God be all the glory.
Yes. So they have been so good. And especially our big mama there, I don't know what we
Sister Adeline, what is your testimony?
Them,
tell us your testimony.
Because without them, I cannot know, I don't know what I will be.
Without God, what has God done for you?
God has done so many things for me, which I cannot, if I want to say it, I'll use the whole day.
I know all of us have testimonies. But what has God done for you specifically? That's what we're
not last do. Year, this year, in March, I was here rooming as a ward. I was frustrating.
You were frustrated, that's right.
I'm really frustrated. But God did what I cannot expect. God really did it.
What did God do?
He gave me, now like this, He has given me 2 houses.
Okay, I'll help her. Hallelujah. Now, she was given a house by the council who gave you a house?
The council.
And then a few weeks after they took the house back, they threw that letter, they said, we are not giving you the house again. And what happened? Tell us, what did God do?
When I came here, we were praying. Papa told me that they are arranging your matter.
Who was here on that day when we were praying here? I said, God is working on you, the matter now. She was sitting down over there. Hallelujah. Amen. You are just standing like that because you think you are the one that answered the prayer. Love for Jesus.
Friday, Sunday, I came here. Then on Monday, I said that the word of the prophecy I've said. So I have to use opportunity to ask for that house.
Yes.
I called the office. I said that, when are you
when are you giving me my house back? When are you taking me out of this place? You've given me a house, you've taken it back. When are you taking me back there? So she acted on the word that came for her. And she said, no, I cannot sit down here and die. I must call them and they must give me the house. So sometimes the word of God that is given to you energizes you to take action. The Bible says that faith without works is dead. And when she called them, and what happened?
immediately they told me that I should wait, I'm coming. The next morning they just said that we are going back to
the same people. You guys don't understand. The same people that say we take the house back. The same people say we are coming to give you back the house. It is not normal. Hallelujah. Say it is not normal. That tells you that wherever you may have been rejected before, as you leave that door, I make a declaration. It shall be breaking news for you in the name of Jesus. The same people will call you and celebrate you in the name of Jesus. So shall it be in Jesus' name. Take glory, Father. Take glory, Son. That job will get down to you this week in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Sit down and never go down. Father, I just thank you for today. I thank you for your goodness, for your kindness, for your mercies. Thank you for the testimonies that have come for. We are praying. Jesus, Lion of the tribe of Judah, you know I don't know how to preach. But I pray for your help and your empowerment today. Send in Isaiah 53, O Lord. That as the word 55, that as the word goes forth, that it shall not go forth and come back void. Lord, speak through me this afternoon.
Amen.
As your word comes forth, let there be mighty deliverances in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let there be mighty breakthroughs in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
As your word comes forth, I declare, Father, launch someone here into new realms of abundance in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Launch someone into new realms of increase in the name of Jesus. Launch someone into new realms of the supernatural in the name of Jesus. Launch someone into new realms of the miracles lost in the name of Jesus. Let immigration breakthrough be released now in the name of Jesus. Let financial breakthroughs be released now in the name of Jesus. And we vow to give you all the glory. In Jesus' name. Clap those hands better for Jesus. I say for Jesus. Hallelujah. What a privilege. Many of you don't understand what privilege it is to see December 2018. Many of you, sometimes I'll call you and give you prophecies about the plans of the enemy. I'm only giving you 5% of what I saw. Because we don't preach a message of fear. Hallelujah. If I give you everything, sometimes it can put fear into you. But regardless of what the enemy has planned, God still kept you. In January, he kept you. In February, he kept you. In March, he kept you. In April, he kept you. Some of you are just looking at me. You don't know what God has done. If you believe and you know that God kept you and did not keep yourself, tell him, thank you, Jesus. Say it like you mean it. Thank you, my Father. You may be seated, please.
Just
like I said, I have 20 minutes or so. I'll not be quick. I'll take my time. I'll not go down there. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
All throughout this year, we established from the Bible that in order to end the year well, all throughout this month, and ease our way into 2019 with peace, with rest, we must draft a plan. We said that 3 weeks ago. And we said a vision without a plan is only a possibility. And we said in whatever you want to do without a plan that you present to God, you end up like others. I'm giving a recap for the new faces I'm seeing here. We said that God has a plan for you, but God does not plan for you. God has a plan for you, but God does not plan for you. Jeremiah 29, 11. God has a plan for you, but God does not plan for you. That is why even in the world that we are now, when a businessman wants to start a business, he drafts a plan. Very important. Hallelujah. Last week, we also said that you must understand that your help is from above. Psalms 46:1. God is our refuge and strength, our ever-present help in times of need. We said that connections will fail you. We said that friends will fail you. We said that contacts will fail you. Many people think because they have a governor in position, it means they are covered. Child of God, no, it does not work like that. There are things that governor may not be able to do for you. Only God can do it for you. Last week we said that if you place your trust in men instead of God, their incapacity will bring about your disability. We said that if you place your trust in men instead of in God, their disposition will affect what? Your position. If you place your trust in men instead of God, their disposition will affect what? Your provision. And we said it was foolishness to boast. It is in your skills. It is foolishness to boast in your talent. It is foolishness to boast in your job. It is foolishness to boast in your connection. It is foolishness to boast in your contact. Because life as a whole is a mystery. Life as a whole is a mystery. And last week we said Naaman was a general from Syria. But humility distinguished him from the others, and he understood the place of location. We started there and we did not end. So today, another principle to help you enter a new year with ease and with your focus is humility. Hallelujah. Say humility.
Humility.
One thing you must understand, that we brought nothing in the world. And for sure when we go, we'll carry nothing along with us. One thing you must know is that whatever you have acquired from January to now, God gave it to you.
Amen.
Whatever you must understand is that humility is the platform for speedy manifestation of testimonies.
Yes, sir.
Humility. If you can understand that because you came out of dust, you will go back to dust, you'll be humble. There is nothing that you have acquired or have seen that did not come from God. Nothing came from you. Many are in church and cannot appropriate the blessings because pride is their problem and they do not even know it. Child of God, pride is a spirit, and many people who are proud do not know they are proud. No matter what they tell them, they'll say you are the one who is proud. They don't understand that pride is a spirit. Many are in church and in their humility, you can see proud. In their humility, they are proud.
Yes.
Sister Catherine called me on Sunday and said, Pastor, I'm very sorry. She's like a mother. Let me put it that way. She's my daughter spiritually, but she's like, I don't want to say mother because the kind of man that is coming to her will be so young. So I don't wanna knock that down. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The way you are saying amen.
Amen.
Shout hallelujah. Where is she? Where is Sister Catherine?
I'm here, sir.
Hallelujah. You used to do, how do they call it?
The
faho. Your hair color.
Yes, sir.
Don't do that again. It repels.
Thank you, sir.
Don't do that again.
Thank you, sir.
When you begin to do the reading now, he's coming.
Amen.
Say amen.
Amen.
I'm just speaking like because last week, you saw I tied my hair.
Okay, I did not notice.
Yes, that is what they told me also.
And you tied it again today?
I tied it because they told me that don't leave your hair again like that.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That is what I just said.
Yeah.
That is what, it repels that one. It attracts the wrong people to you.
Amen.
As a matter of fact, he's not the one. The one is coming.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Sir, I see an arrow dead on your dad, but it is canceled in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
I say it is canceled in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Any report, negative report, medical report?
I've not heard anything.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Any negative report since this year, any negative medical report?
Not what I know.
Since this year, he has never been sick.
Been sick.
Hallelujah. It is canceled in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I told someone to listen, answer. That's how we talk. It might not make sense to you, but prophets are sent to stop something that the enemy is planning. Some of you will think that we exaggerate. We don't exaggerate. We say it as we hear it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Quickly today, we shall look at another principle to finish strong and ease our way into 2019, and that is you must understand the place of humility. You must understand the place of
humility.
Luke 4:25-30. We shall read together. Luke 4:25-30. I'll read verse 25. But I tell you of a truth, you read verse 26, I'll read verse 30 together. Many widows were in Israel in the days of Elijah, when the heavens were shut up 3 years and 6 months, when great famine was throughout all the land. Read verse 26, please. Read it like you mean it, verse 26, and let's read together. And many leopards were in Israel in the time of Elijah the prophet, and none of them was clean, saving Naaman the Syrian. Verse 28, it says, and all day in the synagogue, when they heard these things, were filled with wrath. Verse 29, it says, and rose up and thrust him out of the city, and led him onto the brow of the hill, where all their city was built, that they might cast him down headlong. Verse 30, but he passing through the midst of them, when his way. Say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jesus came to preserve you.
Amen.
So no matter what you are going through now, it is a process.
Yes.
Surely, surely they shall gather together, but not. Say no weapon fashion against. You are answering now, but when there's a problem, you are worried more than me. You can see from those verses that what actually stopped the other people from his hometown was the spirit of pride. What stopped them from receiving was the spirit of pride. What stopped them from receiving was the spirit of pride. Satan was not a liar. Satan was not a thief. Satan was not a fornicator. But what sent him down here was
pride.
Jesus came and was performing miracles in other cities, in other towns. And then he said, I've done so much in other cities. Let me go back to my hometown and begin to bring healing to the land. And when Jesus came back to his hometown, they said of him, for sure, the carpenter's son is back. What happened? The spirit of pride was in place. They began to assess Jesus from where he came from. Some of them said, my God, Jesus, you made it. So you cannot tell me you are a healer now. You cannot tell me you are the son of God. Some of them said, are his brothers and sisters not around us? Why? Because they could not just comprehend that Jesus was a Messiah, because they saw him growing. What was that? The spirit of pride. Shout,
oh Lord,
take away from me
anything that speaks of pride.
Matthew 13:58. And he did not do many miracles there because of their lack of faith. Why? Because you can only appropriate the blessings upon God via humility. Hallelujah. When you are pride, even God is your enemy, sir. He says he resists the pride and give grace to the humble. So when you are proud, God is your number one enemy.
Yes, sir.
Does that make sense?
Yes, sir.
Job 22:29. God brings down the proud and saves the humble. So that tells you that God himself is your number one enemy if you are proud. 1 Peter 5:6 says, humble yourself therefore under God's mighty hand, that he may lift you up in due time. So pride is not something, humility is not something you do one time. That he may lift you up in due time. Guess what? Many people fail and they don't appropriate their blessing because at the age of their miracle, the enemy releases pride. Because the enemy knows that as long as there's pride in that individual, he cannot receive from God. As long as there's pride in that individual, he's the number one enemy of God. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And it happens mostly when people have no perception of things. When people have no perception of the move of God. When people have no perception of what God has ordained in a service like this. You will not know how to honor whom honor is due if you don't have the spirit of perception. Ask yourself, some people say, why must I tithe? Sir, who taught Abraham tithing? Is there anywhere in the Bible where God said, Abraham, go and carry your tithes and give to Melchizedek? No. Perception. Say perception.
Perception.
A woman just stood and she perceived that this is surely a man of God. And that changed her generation forever. And we are still talking about her. Why? Spirit of humility. 2 Kings 4:9, a woman said to her husband, I perceive this is a man of God. And yes, God does not kill people. But the lack of perception is what killed Ananias and Sapphira. The lack of perception. Everything you have ever acquired is given to you by God. Now God gave them a piece of land. They took that piece of land, and because of the favor of God, they sold it like triple the price they bought it from. Now they said to themselves, godly wisdom, that this money is too big for God. They forgot that God gave it to them in the first place. God began to teach me something this morning when I was preparing these notes. He said, yeah, they said tithe is not good. Obviously, that's your own mentality. We all have different opinions. But look now, in the government, tithe in this kingdom is another form of taxes in the world. Tithe in this kingdom is another form of taxes in the world. The only difference is that in the world, they cut it off before it comes to you. But in this kingdom, God is a God of, he will give you the choices. God is not someone who forces himself on people. He will show you the law, he will give you a choice. Hallelujah. I pray that none of us should miss it in the mighty name of Jesus. And when you misplace priority by eating your tithes, you become vulnerable to calamity. That will not be your story in the name of Jesus. Now quickly notice that many Pharisees, those who could not see far, and many Sadducees, those who were so sad, who for Jesus were very educated. And so they were wondering why an unlearned man like Jesus would tell them what to do. And that is a problem in this generation today. Education has not helped much people. Degrees. You can have all the degrees in the world. If you don't make degrees, nothing happens. I know people who do PhD, no job. I know people who all sort of certificate, no job. Why? Because of the spirit of pride. You know, university studies and worldly wisdom teaches you how things work physically, chemically, and economically. But things about God, think about God. God does not operate on the wisdom of men. God does not operate on the wisdom of the world. God does not operate on your own wisdom. Hallelujah. God's ways are not your ways. No wonder the Bible says in 1 Corinthians 2:14, it says that people who aren't spiritual cannot receive these truths from God's spirit. It says it all sounds foolish to them and they cannot understand it. For only those who are spiritual can understand what the spirit of the Lord is saying. And that is why many people say there is no God, because they do not understand the ways of God. Psalms 14:1 says, the fool says in his heart, there is no God. The Bible says, they are corrupt and they do abominable deeds. It says, there is none who does good. Why? They cannot even perceive that the whole world was created by God. How can you tell me that sometimes more than 2,000 years ago, out of nowhere, trees just began to grow. Out of nowhere, trees just began to grow. Out of nowhere, things just began to take place. Out of nowhere, an animal became a man. Put it anyhow, there is a God. Hallelujah. Amen. That is why the world will not understand why you came to church today. That is why the world will not understand why you come to church every week. When I was in my previous church, I used to go to church 5 times a week. Sometimes 6 times, my wife is here. Sometimes 7 times. I'll be going. Hallelujah. Every time you come in the presence of the Lord, he services you.
Hallelujah.
It's like servicing the Gaza.
Yes,
every time you enter, yes, something changes.
Yes.
I know that God is healing someone now in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
I don't like that amen at all.
Yes.
Many will not understand why you pay your tithes. Then no one question why they pay taxes to the government. Nothing in this kingdom makes sense, child of God. God did not come to make sense. In fact, God came to make disciples. It does not make sense that Moses stretched his hand and they were having victory. It does not make sense that Daniel was in the lion's den and he came back whole. It does not make sense that Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were in the fire and they came back without no burn, nothing. Because a fallen man is in the fire. The things of this kingdom are hidden. things. The Bible says secret. Until you sit down and settle with God, you cannot understand. It does not make sense. How a woman who never had a relationship could conceive a child? No, sir. That's the problem. They say, how could she conceive? If the things of God don't make sense at all. It does not make sense that I have a master's and I'm preaching the word of God. It does not make sense. But when you perceive what God has ordained for you, I was talking earlier, he said, we share an inheritance with Christ. You don't understand? We share. So can you tell me you pay all these bills and you are still fine? I say, yes, of course, it is my culture because I understand kingdom principles.
Amen.
So do you say that King David and the wife said, Pastor, you are going to Nigeria. We know you have a responsibility. Let's pay your flight. And I said no. I said no because I understand culture. The culture of this kingdom. Have you noticed, child of God, rich people don't, they don't talk about riches. Rich people are simple people. It is only poor people who have seven phones. Nobody's calling them.
Hallelujah.
When you understand the culture of the kingdom, you don't need to tell someone you're a millionaire.
No, sir.
They can smell it.
My God.
Hallelujah. Yeah. We share an inheritance with Christ. It means whatever Christ died for, it belongs to you.
Amen.
When he was hung on that cross, he said, sickness is gone. Yes. He said, poverty is gone. He said, you are rich. Yes. He said, I became poor that you may become rich.
Yes.
So it is an abomination to this kingdom to be broke.
Yes, sir.
The daughter of Obama, when you see her trekking, it's an error.
Yes,
if you ever see the daughter of Obama trekking, it is an error. Many are suffering in church because of lack of understanding of the scriptures, lack of understanding of their inheritance in Christ Jesus. After now, you are going home with a testimony in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It does not make sense how a man will part the Red Sea into two. The things of God are mystery. To succeed daily in this kingdom, child of God, forget what you know. Say, forget what you know. If you want to succeed in this kingdom, keep your senses away. At one point, I was meant to pay the house. That was many years ago. I did not have money. I had money. Don't get me wrong. My check is still hanging to today. Hallelujah. It's coming to pass. So the money I had, I had to pay my tithes. And if I had to pay the house, it means I would have entered my tithe. So that month, I would not have paid my tithe. Guess what? I decided to pay my tithe. And that same day,
Hallelujah.
Double enter my account.
Yeah.
Kingdom principles.
Yes,
kingdom principles. You follow kingdom principles. Why others are saying there's a casting down, you will say that. Don't begin to say those verses if you are not following principles. God is not a respecter of your words. God is a respecter of principles.
Yes,
in this government, if you go against the rules of this government, you'll go to prison. In this kingdom, if you go against the rules of God, you will have nothing. If you don't follow the principles of God, that's why you can see people can be in church for 30 years. Nothing to show for. But someone who just came yesterday and he is practicing the principles of the kingdom. Before you know it, he's succeeding. And you are wondering, what is he doing? What secret is he applying? No secret, sir. The kingdom. The word of God are guaranteed promises. You do what God wants you to do, he will bless you accordingly. That's why a pastor can be preaching and there's nothing to eat in his house. Why? Because he is talking the word, but he's not doing the word. Be what? Doers of the word.
Yes, sir.
Doers of the word. Be doers of the word and not hearers only. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Think about it, child of God. Why do many talk about Jesus, sing about Jesus, but do not know him or know what Jesus stands for or know what Jesus represents? Because of pride. Every day you don't come to church, it is pride. If you went to work, thank God for you. But as long as many people tell you, oh, I have my studies, I have my business, I have this to look after, guess what? You have misplaced priorities. We live in a generation where women, some women also want to be, they want to be, God has an order. When you violate that order, you violated the principle of God. no matter how you cry, nothing happened. God made a man before a woman. I'm not saying we live in a generation of gender equality. Does that make sense? Somebody should not go here and get me wrong. But what I'm saying is that God said the man is the prophet of the house. No, don't get me wrong. It is not to oppress the wife. It is not to beat the wife. It is not to torment the wife. He is the priest of the house. If now you as a woman go and overtake that man, the children are automatically knocked over. Principles. Those are the principles of the kingdom. It's like the principles of your job site. They are rules that they make. And no matter how you cry, God is saying, you have overturned my order. If you overturn God's order, what happened? The blessing will come to you in the name of Jesus. Amen. I said the blessing will come to you in the name of Jesus. Amen. The spirit of pride wants many to go where they don't teach kingdom principles. The spirit of pride wants you to go where they sing about the Jesus you don't know. But they don't want you to know principles of the kingdom that will give you the perception and bring about victory every day. Sir, ma, if the Bible was not a guaranteed promise, I will never hold a mic. Many are suffering and many cannot come to church because they look at us, some of us in Christians. They say, this, why would I be a Christian? When God called me, I was looking at pastor. I said, me, pastor, how? I said, I cannot be the pastor. Why? Because of the kind of things I was seeing around me. The kind of magic, the kind of things they were doing in the kingdom. But God began to tell me that, son, you can be in a place and come last and be the latest. Yes. If you follow kingdom principles. Amen. It is not who came first, sir. It is not who came after. It is who follows kingdom principle. He says, if you are willing and obedient, you shall eat the best of the land.
Yes, sir.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Child of God, it is perception as a runner that helps you understand that every time you attend church, you are service. And that it is more real to be present in church than to be watching on TV. The Bible says, don't forsake the assembly of the believers as some have the habit of doing. Some have the habit of coming to church only during festive period. Do not forsake the assembly of the believer. Maybe that week God, the enemy may have released an accident. Because you are here, it cannot touch you, sir.
Amen.
Those are principles of the kingdom. Whenever Moses went to the mountain, he came back with the glory of God. When he went down there, they were all covered with the glory, except those who had to violate prophetic instruction. In fact, as a matter of fact, those who had to violate prophetic instruction, God himself at one point opened the ground and swallowed them. And the Bible says that God regretted it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Why? Because they violated prophetic principles. It is perception that teaches you that it is good to dwell in peace with everyone in church. It is perception that teaches you that it is good to help those in need. It is perception that teaches you that it is good to dwell in peace with your wife. It is perception that teaches you that it is good to dwell in peace with your husband. It is perception that pushes you to come to church every service. Because you understand that upon when a fire ministry, there shall be deliverance.
Oh, yes.
And those who are there on that day will receive their deliverance. Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Even General Naaman of Syria understood the place of perception via humility when he needed help. I said, world-renowned general, how can you imagine that a world-renowned general could listen to the instructions of a servant? You know how people treat servants these days. But a general, he tells you that Naaman, the general, was approachable. He was approachable. Why? Because of humility. He could have just told her, shut up. You don't talk in my house as some people do. But Naaman the general stood down and listened to the servant. Listen to her. Many of us looking at me, your wife cannot talk. Many of us looking at me, your husband cannot talk. Many of us looking at me, a friend cannot give you advice and you take it. In fact, not just say take it, you don't want to hear. God used a servant, a girl who was not even from, the man was a Syrian, that girl was a Jew. that he stood down and listened to her. Why? The spirit of humility. A slave boldly went to his master because she knew the master was approachable and said, "Master, where you took me from as a slave, you know this your leprosy. The prophet in that land can heal you." And he listened. Child of God, I am here. In your quest for humility, there will be a test. Can you be in church if God makes you a millionaire today? Every time God wants to promote you, he will give you the test of humility. Can you sit at the back if the ushers tells you to sit at the front? Can you sit at the front if the ushers tells you to sit at the back?
Yes.
The test of humility. He did not just end there. And the servant said, "Let's go." And they began to go. Now he spent all that time going to where the servant was taking him to, only for him to get there. He was a royalty. And the prophet said, "I will not see you." He humbled himself and waited for the right time. What did the prophet do? He gave an instruction. And Naaman gave up. He said to the servant, "Let's go back." And the servant said, "Master, you know you drove this far not to come here and miss your miracle. Humble yourself before the Lord, and in due time he will lift you up." He went to the pool to bath 7 times. He went the first time, nothing happened. Can you imagine? A general, first time nothing happened, second time nothing happened. I believe he was discouraged. I believe he told the servant, "You know what? It is enough. Let's go back." And the servant kept speaking to him, "Naaman, persevere one more time. Persevere one more time." And he listened till the 7th time. The Bible says, the 7th time, his skin was like that of a newborn
baby. Wow. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Humility.
Humility. The Lord began to teach me this morning that most of us, called you humble in church, outside. Today, we are proud in disguise. Ask yourself, can you still sing in the choir if you had a business empire tomorrow?
Yes.
Can you still go around and beat people to church if God gave you a Bentley?
Hallelujah.
2 pastors have told me that, "Pastor, you are not supposed to be picking people in church." I say, "You don't know where I come from." When you know where I come from, you'll pick them to church.
Hallelujah. Amen. Amen.
Sir, ma, when you pick people to church, it changes nothing from your being. When you pick people and bring, we are all giving the gospel of reconciliation.
Amen.
When was the last time a brother fell and you held the hand and said, "Let's pray"? Many will do that as an opportunity to backbite and to criticize. Why? Pride in this guy. Pride to a fall. Humility is not weakness, but humility is power under control. Humility is preferring everyone else above yourself. Humility is a man or a woman who comes into church and begin to ask, "What can I do? How can I help? Where should I sit?" Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is why the Bible says in Philippians 2:6-8, "And Jesus being found in fashion as a man," the Bible says, "he humbled himself and became obedient unto death." So everything Jesus did, he had to consult the Father first.
Yes.
Humility.
Amen.
The master of the universe, the one who holds the whole world in his hand, had to humble himself and became man for your sake.
Amen.
The Bible says we are imitators of Christ. So if he did it, we ought to do it.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Stand up on your feet and begin to thank God for the word that came forth. We don't have the time. Father, we thank you. Lord, we celebrate you. Lord, we rejoice you. Maria kata la kata. Lekete lekete malakata lakata. Ipakanoko lekete lekete. Makiakata. Thank you, man. Thank you, man. Thank you. Father, we bless you. Lord, we celebrate you. In Jesus' name, we are praying. As a matter of fact, I have never seen anyone I don't like. Not possible, sir. I've been out there doing charity and people were vomiting blood on me. I stood there and I held them. People have come here, they were smelling urine. I gave them a hug. We carried them in the car. We brought them to church. Because you came from dust and when you die, you go back to dust.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Yes.
So I want to say my hands will be dirty. My clothes will be dirty. Who gave you the clothes you are wearing? God gave it to you. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus. Say, I have heard your word. Release on me, O Lord, to live a life of humility. Let it fall on me now. Open your mouth and pray that prayer. The grace to live a life of humility. The grace to live the life of humility. The grace to know where I come from. The grace to know that God is the God of the universe. Are you praying that prayer? Makakatorokoshe. Lekekete lekete. Makoko telekete. Lalie panakata lakata. Ekoko lekete lekete. Makia kanakata lakata. Lepanakata lakata. Thank you and thank you and thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we are praying. Some of us looking at me now, we have never been hugged before. In fact, as a matter of fact, nobody has ever told us Jesus loves us. I want us to go around. If you want to give them a hug, you want to greet them, just tell them that Jesus loves you. Hope we go around, just tell them. Tell them, go to people that you have not seen before. Tell them that Jesus loves them. Jesus loves them. Jesus gave his life for you. Jesus loves you. Jesus gave his life for you. Quiet, please. Oh, come, oh, ye faithful, joyful and triumphant. Oh, come, Jesus' name we are praying. Amen. Let us share the grace. May the grace of our Lord Jesus,